And his kick is no good as this one stays 6-0. Elliott now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On first down, Luck. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Second and 10, Luck again. And he comes back with one complete. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Give the Colts 13 yards and a first down. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. It used to be occasional, right, safety valve, throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Play action. It's Luck. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
When the big kind of guy trying to cover him, it is really, really tough for the defender to get through him to make a play on the football. That's why guys love to throw that route down the middle, throw it deep, and let the big guy go get it.
This will be caught just inside the 10. Only a yard on the completion. It's second and goal.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Throwing again is Luck. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. And they will line up now for the 2-point try. Again, Luck. That's caught at the 2. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. First down, it's Luck. And an alley to run. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. 16 yards to pick up there. The Colts have a first down. Here on first down. It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, How tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Block on third down. Open man is Henderson. That's complete. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Point after now from Sturgis. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. First and 10, Locke. Throw right side, going to be taken in by Henderson. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Well, there wasn't much there with that hitch route. They didn't gain what they expected. But sometimes when you call a hitch, you really don't have an alternate to go to. You don't have a second route to throw it to. So sometimes you have to wipe it in there and hope for the best.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Anytime a ball is thrown in the middle of the field, it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Wide open receiver complete. And he's got a first. The play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. On second and 10, Locke. Over the middle, complete. That's Bailey. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
To throw is Locke. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this. Or keeps hitting the calculator, but my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate. That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Luck able to find Hilton there for a Colt first down. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to Tennessee after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play,
he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker.
Taking a gander at the NFL scoreboard in Minneapolis. Early lead in that one for the Packers. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. So that'll back him up 5.
Still first down.
Out of the gun, Luck. Throw left side, complete. It's Mullins. And he'll get it up a little shy of the 15. They'll spot him down at the 14-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll make this a 2nd and 13. A shotgun snap for Luck. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up 3rd down. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
3rd and long, it's Locke. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. It'll be a gain of 17 and an Indianapolis first down. Now it's Locke. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. T.Y. Hilton, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. Locke on 2nd down. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. And now prior to this 3rd and 1, we're going to get a timeout here, as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number 1. The Colts on 3rd down. No problems to this point. A perfect 5 for 5. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. Throwing is Locke. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. He was superb a week ago. 3 sacks in that affair. Now 1 here in the 2nd quarter.
Well, how about our conversations this week? With him, it's pretty simple. He said, I've got a few combinations I can trot out they haven't seen yet. And on the flip side, they thought they had a plan to block him. Might need to come up with something else, because he looks like he's getting loose now.
Punch, counter punch.
fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect. But as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. The final shot before the break. Lock. He's going to air one out. It's caught inside the 25. So we come to halftime here with the visiting Colts taking. And hello, I guess Larry's halftime show is buttoned through. And we are moving on and ready to go for the third quarter. Returning it, Carlos Henderson. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now trotting back out with the rest of his offensive mates. Out come the Colts. They'll have it first here to start quarter number three. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. They have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Give the Colts 13 yards and a first down. So the offense has it first and 10. From the gun, here's Locke. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Bailey. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
So it'll be first down here after the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. Strong run, but still wrangled before reaching the 20. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
The way things have gone in this one, the running game's been something of an afterthought, and that's not been too bad for them, has it?
Yeah, the offensive returns have been good, but I guess we figured he and the ground game would be a bit more involved. On 2nd down, here's Love. And he spots Henderson open left side. He takes it to the 15. A nice display of power. That gives him a nice pickup. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down. The Colts on 3rd down. They haven't been stopped yet. A perfect 7 for 7. Here it's 3rd and 3. Now Luck. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and nine. They snap it to Locke. And that is going to be incomplete. Chuck Pagano decides to go. It doesn't work. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go-around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Caught left side, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one for Indianapolis, resulting in 15 yards and a fresh set of downs. Luck on first down. Wide open receiver complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A good pickup there, a 22. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Luck throwing again. Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down.
How many times have we sat with coordinators, and especially the defensive guys, they talked about big plays, sacks, they often come in bunches. Well, it may not be a bunch here, but that is the third sack of the game for them.
And around the sack three or four, you think it starts to get in the quarterback's head a little bit.
Not just
the... And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by T.J. McDonald, and he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. But they needed a break. They needed to make... And the Colts coming out now. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finish off the drive, it does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
And that catch puts him past the great Jerry Rice for the most receiving yards in a single season. He's now up over 1,848.
At one point, we called Jerry Rice Flash. How about the dash we saw here today? The dash towards his record and past it. What a tremendous achievement. And how much fun is it for us to be here to witness it?
It's a pinch me moment for us. Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
They'll fake it. Now Locke. His throw incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Here's Locke. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Now A Colts offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. Now, the previous drive, they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 17. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Luck. Launching one for Henderson. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
Not too many missteps in the red zone thus far. He was going for his fifth touchdown pass. His man couldn't shake free there, but boy, you know he's going to take another shot before this one's over.
Yeah, exactly, because you know three is good, four is excellent. You get five, that's a whale of a game. The Colts on third down. They've been really good, converting 7 of their 10 tries. This is third and 10. To the air again, Luck. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. The passing game for the Colts finding its stride, another first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
From the red zone now, Luck. This will be caught just inside the 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
One of the selling points at the end route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
Here's Luck. Time for a break. To the sideline. Wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it, but he is able to keep the feet in bounds. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Luck. And that is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. Score now for Baltimore. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. If they hold on, it would be win number 10 for them on the year. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the NFL, that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it. When they first started talking about this game, leading up to it during the week, going on the road, unfamiliar city, obviously, unfamiliar hotel. No one's going to be with you once you get to the stadium. They're all going to be against you. You name it, all those things they had to deal with, they were able to conquer them and do it convincingly.
Yeah, they did it very convincingly, and now the final moments of this one. So here we go, first and 10 now. So Luck is out on the sidelines getting looked at. And they'll hand things over to the USC product, a former fourth-round selection, Matt Barkley. And too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And that one is incomplete. He just dropped it. But they're up big on the scoreboard, so maybe he can chuckle about later.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
Here's Barkley. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Mad at me cause it's poppin'. They don't wanna put some money in my pocket.